Dancers, I hope you're all having an amazing day. Now, I'm super excited for this video. Before we start, can you just make sure you subscribe? I have new videos coming every single week, so make sure you hit that little bell, hit that little subscribe button, and also make sure you follow me on my Claudia Dean World, Collections by Claudia, and Coach Me World Instagram, because I'm gonna start involving all of my Instagram followers as well into my videos, because one of you had this video idea and it's so genius. Okay. Basically, I asked you all what videos you wanted to see, and one of you came back and said, Claudia, I really want you to react to other dance studios' rules that they have at their dance school. So what I've got you all to do is send me through your dance studio rules, and I'm gonna be reacting to them, and there's all sorts of ones. I've done my best not to read them because I really want you to hear my genuine reaction. So I just think let's get straight into the video. Make sure you don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And okay, this is all anonymous, by the way, but the first one is no TikToks with a sad face. I actually think I disagree with that. I think TikToks in like the waiting area and all of that is absolutely fine, because at the end of the day, TikTok is dancing. Like, it's actually learning routines and it's actually dancing, and it's quite hard. So I actually think, like, in the waiting area, as you warm up, I think that's fine to throw out a TikTok. Like, I think that's fine. But I think definitely once you're in the studio, absolutely not. Like, you need to focus on what you're doing in the classroom. But I think in the waiting area, it's totally fine to do TikToks. Like, I don't see why not. I mean, maybe the teacher that is saying that, they're quite old school and they don't understand the app. So I think maybe if they don't understand the app, then they're probably gonna be against it. But I think if you know how TikTok works, you know that you've gotta literally dance and do dance choreography and combos, I think you'd be fine with it. So yeah, I kind of disagree with that one. Okay, this next one came through so much. Everyone has to wear black head to toe except the little ones who wear pink tights. We even have to wear black skirts too. I sort of agree with this, but at the same time I don't. I think the only thing and the only benefit to having everyone wearing the same color is that everyone looks very uniformed and it looks very like clean and tidy. But then I also think that dance is all about being creative. And I think part of that is wearing like creative leotards, wearing different outfits, like leotards and skirts, I mean. And I think it's really fun for dancers to be able to wear what they feel. Like, for example, you know, with fashion, like you wear what makes you feel confident. And I think it should be the same thing in dance as well. I feel like it's important that people can express themselves with what color leotard they're wearing. So the only benefit is that everyone looks very similar and uniformed, but then I also think it doesn't really allow everyone to express themselves. That would be the only downside. So yeah, I mean, I'm really big on like buying all different leotards and like having the variety of wearing different things. I think it keeps it really fun rather than like wearing the same color all the time. I mean, that's gotta get boring. I did it actually at the Royal Ballet School. We had to wear different colors depending on what year we were in, but because it changed every single year, you sort of wouldn't really get too sick of it. But I think if you literally had to wear black for like 8 years straight, I feel like you would get sick of that, definitely. Ooh, this one's actually an interesting one. You have to audition in order to take exams, either intermediate, foundation, or higher in ROD. I mean, look, again, I actually kind of disagree with this. I honestly feel that every single person that decides to dance should have the opportunity to take exams if that's the direction that they wanna go in. Because not everyone wants to even go down that direction, but most people do. And I think if someone's willing and they're hardworking enough to wanna go down that path, then I feel like they're gonna prove themselves in the process of taking the exam. I think it's a little bit savage to make people audition to do an exam, because I think, you know, then where are you getting your feedback either? When you do an exam, that's how you actually get feedback to then improve for the following year. So that means that those select amount of people that do get accepted to do their exam, they get the feedback, but then the people that don't, that might need it even the most, they're not getting any type of feedback. Like, I think that's quite unfair, really. And I think also too, the benefit of doing exams is that you're getting an unbiased opinion. And I think that's really important as well, because your dance teacher will get so used to your good and bad habits. So I think it is really important to have someone from the outside look at you. So those people aren't even getting that. Yeah, to me, I actually find that really savage and really unfair. Ooh, some of these are gonna make me angry. Nah, I'm kidding, but some of them, I'm like, wow.
Wow.
This one, I didn't have to wear a leotard or a bun during class, so I moved, like transferred schools. I definitely think that should be a rule. I think if you undertake classical ballet and if you are doing classical ballet, you need to turn up looking the part. You need to have your hair a certain way. You do need to wear a leotard so the teacher can see your leg line, your foot line. I think that is almost like a respect thing as well to the art. So I fully agree with you there. I think I would definitely, I'd probably look at moving schools if that like respect factor wasn't really there for the art. Like I think it is very important to look a certain way when you turn up for class, and I think it just shows that you care about your appearance and the way that your hair is and the leotard that you're wearing. I think that's very important. Okay. I mean, I don't want to ruffle feathers here, but no point shoes that aren't from block. Now, I think this is pretty rude to dancers. I think, honestly, every dancer is different and every dancer's foot and body requires a different brand. That's why there are so many brands, because there's not one brand that can cater for heaps of people. Like, trust me, there's not. It's very difficult to do that. So I think it's pretty rude for dance schools to have that in place, actually. I think that you should be entitled to wear whatever brand shoe that fits your foot and that suits your foot. So yeah, I actually really disagree with that. I think you should be entitled to wear what you want. Okay, this is weird. Someone's just said, tell Miss, which I'm guessing is the teacher, if you are on your period. Wait, what? Why? Okay, wait, if I look at it from another point of view, maybe it's because like if you're on your period, you couldn't do certain steps, or like maybe, I don't know, but still, I think like you just excuse yourself and just ask her to the toilet and like, I don't know, get comfortable before you go back into class. Do you know what I mean? Full sole flats for senior ballet students. Oh boy. No, I think that is so old fashioned. I think full sole is just, no one wears it. Even in a company, no one wears them anymore. Like, I think actually maybe it would be beneficial for younger grades, but I think as you get older, you should have the option for split sole or full sole, in my opinion, because you want to try and make your foot look as archy as possible. Whereas in the younger grades, the full sole would really encourage you to work and articulate through your foot. So I agree with the younger ones, but the senior ones, no way. I think by then you know how to work your foot, or you should know if you've been trained correctly, and you should have the option to wear split sole. I don't know if this one's a joke, but it's, if we're chewing gum, they stick it out on our foreheads during the whole class. What? What? Are you serious? That is just unnecessary. Wouldn't you just say, can you please take your gum out? And the person would take it out, they put it on your head. What? Some of these are so whack. This one's a bit controversial. No drinks other than water. I mean, you know what? I think that is good, because I do think that everyone's upbringing is so different. Like, some kids are allowed to drink juice, other kids aren't. Some kids are allowed to drink soft drink, other kids aren't. So I think like if everyone's just drinking water, then you know, no one's going, oh, you know, I wish I could have some of her Coca-Cola, or wish I could have some of her apple juice, like, or Powerade, or like energy drinks. I think that's actually quite fair, to be honest. And I think too, you are, you know, doing ballet, you're dancing, and you're exhausting yourself and you'll be sweating. So I think it's important that you do stay really hydrated with the right things. So I kind of agree with that. But at the same time, you know, on the other hand, it's kind of like, well, everyone's kind of entitled to drink what they want to drink, you know? It's, yeah, that's a tough one. Guys. Ow. Whole film crew's laughing at this. Wait. No ducks are allowed in the waiting room or in the studios because someone brought baby ducks one day. Why do I find that so funny? I think because some of these are so random. I think the random ones, like the ones that are super like odd, I think it's because like they've had a very odd experience and they've had to be like super specific, like no ducks in the waiting area. I thought it said no dogs originally, and I was like, yeah, well, that's pretty fair, even though I'm like so biased towards Romeo. What? In another studio, we used to have to wash the studio every week and the toilet. That is so unfair. Get a cleaner. Are you serious? Some studios make their kids wash the studio. Oh my God, that is not okay. Seriously, that is not okay. Wow. We have to wear blue eyeshadow for comps. Nah. Seriously, that I think used to be a thing like 20 years ago. I'm not sure why. Maybe it used to make people's like eyes look bigger on stage. I have no idea, but I just think no. It's light browns, neutrals only, I think. And I think that goes with everything as well, like all of your costumes. I would no way tell anyone to wear blue eyeshadow. I cannot believe this is true. At our studio, you can't do ballet if you're not 5'6" in height or weigh an exact amount. What? Like, dance is for everyone. This baffles me. I cannot believe that. That actually like makes me a little bit mad. Wow.
Wow.
Okay, this one's pretty funny. If you lean on the bar or the wall, you've got to do 10 burpees. I think this is good. I mean, again, I think there's some sort of discipline when it comes to classical ballet, and you just can't really be seen to just like chill on the bar or the wall. Like, it's not the best look. So I think obviously your teacher's trying to drill in some sort of discipline there. So I think it's pretty fair. I mean, the 10 burpees, I mean, I'd struggle to do 10 burpees, to be honest. I think that's pretty hard. Like, does that actually happen? Does anyone else's studio have that rule? It was actually so funny reading through these dances. Like, there are some in here that I can't even say because I'm like, is that real? Like, and they're so specific. I think that's the funny thing about it. They're so specific because they've obviously had an experience, like the teachers had an experience that scarred them. So they've had to like lay down the most ridiculous rule. I hope you enjoyed this video. I thought it was really different and fun, and definitely there's some rules in there that I'm like, that is just so whack. But thank you all so much for watching, and of course, I will see you in my next video. If you want a part two as well, let me know, because there's so many in here that I could literally go on for days, okay? Anyway, love you all lots. I'll see you soon. Bye.